Hey, everybody, Overseas Madman coming at you with another video, like always and forever. Okay, so everyone, the drops last night were very, very crazy. They went in a matter of milliseconds, not even seconds, but milliseconds. I was very lucky to snag a couple packs, but for some reason, I whitelisted the browser's page, I removed my Adblock Plus. As you can see here, I've never enabled Adblock Plus on Atomic Hub or Nifty Blocks or any of those websites, and I just couldn't seem to get the pop-ups to come up. It kept saying pop-up blocked on some of them. I was like, what the heck is going on? What do you mean pop-up blocked? I've allowed pop-ups, everything. That doesn't make any sense. Either way, I did manage to get two wood packs and two little love packs. The wood packs were courtesy of one of my friends. That way we had like an equal chance. He didn't have the wax to buy them. So I just went ahead and sent him the extra wax just in hopes that I could at least get something. And I did. I did get two little love packs and two ancient wood packs. I'm going to be opening those on stream right now. So yeah, let's go ahead and look at the prices of a few things first, and there's a couple other things I'd like to talk about before we get started with those unpacks. Okay, so first things first, everybody. Let's go ahead and look at the calculator here, and let's look at the current rate of the market. So right now, food's at 0.372, wood's at 0.960, and gold is at 0.618. Why are people freaking out? It doesn't make any sense to me. The profits are still there. Even if the profit is lower than what it has ever been before, or at least back into the initial days, there's no reason to complain. You're making money. Even if your investment was a little bit high, you're still collecting money on that investment every single day. Once those numbers start to turn red, like we've seen before, where gold was stupid expensive and wood was like not able to compensate for those changes, then that's the time to start complaining. People, the IDO hasn't even been released yet. We're just now getting to the drops. How do we make people happy? There is never any certainty in life. You can never please everybody. This isn't one of those just get rich in one day type of projects. If you're just here to flip packs and etc., go for it. That's okay. Good money to be made from flipping packs. But if you're in it for the long run, this is the game to be in. The IDO is coming. They have been putting things on the back burner that are not so important, and they're focusing on things that are important. I do feel like they should be addressing more people's concerns, but as you can see, as of lately, the moderators and supporters have been in the chat more than ever. They're taking time to try to answer all the requests that people make, and when people make a request that they can't answer, just have some patience. You know, most of these people are on NDAs. You know, they can't disclose information that is not allowed for them to disclose. You need to have a little bit of patience, okay? Like, even a chainsaw right now, the craft price is 22,000 wax, and you're pulling 1,000 wax a day with it. What is there to complain about? That's like $700 a day just from it. And you can see it just shifted right now because the market is constantly shifting. This is the crypto space, everybody. Crypto is extremely volatile, but as long as profits are to be made, I don't see any reason to complain. Obviously, people who did buy in at the hype, you know, it's no different than when people bought Bitcoin at the hype and then boom, 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 it came down. And then they sold it. They panic sold it. And then when Bitcoin went higher than it was before, people were crying because they just couldn't hold on. I understand a lot of people can't take the financial risk like that. Like maybe you put too much money in than you could afford to lose. That makes perfect sense why you would panic and want to sell out. But if you're one of those people that is interested in investing in things, you have the extra money to liquidate into projects like this, you're happy right now because you're obviously making profits every day. Even if your return turned into 60 days, that is big. 60 days is huge. Go take a loan out from the bank and open a business, and you're not guaranteed any profit. Right now, you are guaranteed profit with this project. It's guaranteed. Even if the return's longer than you expect it to be, the profit is still there. Once these numbers start to turn red, that's the time to complain and really take a look at what's going on. Okay, so the next thing I'd like to talk about is the Prospectors IO. I don't have a reference link set for this yet, but I will put one in the video's description. So if you are going to sign up to this project, please use my reference link. It is free to play. You can actually play this game for free. The only hiccup is everybody starts in the center, okay? So when you start in the center, you have to travel to a free plot if you want to mine on it. Unless you plan on purchasing a plot, and then it's all open game. It's kind of hard to see my characters right here, but I do have three characters. I'm going to go ahead and make them go to work real quick. Okay, so 41 minutes is the max time I can make them work right now because they haven't fully rested. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. Actions completed successfully. Let's do it again for the next guy. Well, that was a girl, the first one. Okay, so my workers are back in action. If you guys do plan on joining this game and checking it out, we do have an alliance on here. Let me find it in the list real quick. It's called overseas.mm. We only have three members right now. It was created by an amazing person that is absolutely dedicated to this game. He goes ham on projects, and he always picks the ones that seem very successful. This guy is amazing. Yeah, so you guys should come over here and check this game out. I'm gonna go ahead and not put too much of a spotlight on this because it's not like the main focus of debate for today. I want to go over a couple different things here. I want to look at the market. Well, let's look at the floor prices on these new ancient stone axes, which I don't know why people are just throwing these on the market. In the Discord, they clearly said that. Let's see. Even though the stone axe is considered a superior version, it has its own function and value. So we don't even know what's coming with these ASAs yet. These ancient stone axes, there could be some utility that a lot of people might miss out on by flipping them on the market, especially under the pack price. People, I don't know why you're flipping things for a loss. It doesn't make any sense to me. Just hold on to something for a little bit. There's no reason to just completely turn it onto the market. Let's go ahead and filter things by tools real quickly, and let's take a peek at what's going on. Okay, so people are selling them for 199 wax. That doesn't make much sense to me. People, you probably should be holding on to these as they look like they're going to have some serious utility into the future. They haven't even released the update yet. There's so many things to come. People are just being super impatient. It's really not fair to the project and the developers because they are trying their best right now. They're trying to make things work. They're working on the reward rates. They're working on different things, trying to keep the economy stable. They're actually swallowing some of the economy just to keep the values up. They're actively trying to make things a little bit better. A lot of people said I have a sort of a bias, like I'm the teacher's pet, as one guy says. I don't know what this guy's problem is. He's constantly irritated at me in the Discord. No reason as to why. I've always helped every single person out. Yeah, so it might take a minute here to find the floor price on the stone axe because the way it's set right now, I can't just, search it like that because if I type stone axe, it'll pull up these ancient ones as well. So it does look like the floor price for the stone axe is hovering around 850 wax at the moment. This is the bottom one. Yeah, so 850 to maybe 890 wax. 880 wax looks like it's around the moving price. Yeah, so the stone axes are super cheap right now. And the funny thing is about it is a stone axe is making 21 wax per day. That's like, $16 or something, maybe $15. That's big, that's like a 35-day return on your investment with the current market values. Let's take a look something real quick here. Look at the 7-day volume and the 24-hour volume, people. This is ridiculously lower than it has ever been. So this is a big reason why these tokens are not so popular right now, in their price. But they're still number one on Alcor. And the reason why the volume is down here is because there's other exchanges that you can trade these on, people. You can trade these in other places. If other exchanges are adapting these EOSIO tokens, it is a big thing. Just look at, like, this one is kind of a poop one, I don't mean to say bad about a project, but this token is absolutely terrible. I've got like 440 of these things on my other account, and it's just been a complete loss on them. I did flip their packs for profit, but yeah, this token is completely not so good. Negative 96.2% in 7 days. You know, everything's kind of falling around the same scales. If we go ahead and let's take a peek at something that I don't think anyone else ever even looks at. Nobody's really paying attention to like what's going on the other markets. Take a peek here, everybody, and look at the trends, okay? So Bitcoin itself is pretty much the standard for crypto. It holds the heaviest weight, and almost every single token on here is going to follow the same pattern. This goes for WAX, it goes for every single token. Obviously, you know, poop coins like Shiba and stuff like that are just kind of pump and dumps. Yeah, so if you really take a look at the graphs here, nearly all of them follow the same trend as Bitcoin, because Bitcoin is the moving standard. Let's look at WAX, okay? WAXP is in the same ballpark, okay? Everybody, take a peek at WAXP, all right? It's not as volatile, and it's not making as drastic of changes, but is directly impacted by the prices of Bitcoin. So keep that into perspective, and, you know, corrections are to come. Let me just go ahead and close this one out. Okay, so let's go ahead and move on to a few other things. I wanted to look at the market value for a chainsaw. So a chainsaw is going for a ridiculously cheap price right now. Oh, I'm sorry. I searched that in the wrong spot. Let me go back up to the top here. Chain. Let's filter it by chain. Let's see what's going on. What's the lowest price one on Atomic Hub? $19,000. So $19,000, and you're pulling like 1,000 WAX a day. It would take you roughly maybe, I'm going to give it like a good estimate, like 25 to 35 days to pay off a chainsaw, as long as the tokens stay the same prices. Obviously, if they dip down, it'll take a little bit longer. But if they dip, you know, in the positive direction and they go up again, I shouldn't say dip. If they rise in the positive direction, obviously those return days are going to decrease. That's just the way it works. The reason why gold has taken such a big hit is there are a lot of new people that are getting into the game, and they're going just for farming. Let me boost my chair up here a little bit. So people are going for the farming. It is a big amount of gold to be made. Farming is pretty much like the mini excavator at the moment. So yeah, the gold price is obviously saturated, the wood price is saturated, and the food price is saturated. There are many tools. There is not a lot of burn mechanics right now, which are probably coming. The game is constantly working on their IDO, they're working on governance, and they're going to release tokenomics. Another thing that I would like to address here, let me pull it up in the other window, that way like I don't accidentally leak any of my emails or anything like that. I really don't want people, you know, trying to brute force their way into my stuff or locking me out of it because they're constantly trying to get in. Let's go ahead and let me go to their page. Let me pull up an old announcement here. This one is very important, everybody. A lot of people don't understand where the money is going, and it's kind of confusing to me that, you know, the developers and the team take the time to put all of this information out for people and nobody takes the time to read it. Okay, so withdraw fee and partnership program. As you all know, when converting the resources, you do have to pay a withdraw fee, which is updated every hour. Okay, so the purpose of these fees: to pay the partnership program partners. They have 20 media partners around the world. They're expanding daily. Recruit more experts for future plans to build and develop content continuously. So they're paying for their team. They're paying for their support. Add exchange liquidity, system maintenance, and support player. So all the people that are complaining, oh, look at all the millions of WAX they're pulling out every day. It's not like they're just running away with the money. They're actually putting it into exchange liquidity, system maintenance, and supporting the players. They're paying for advertisements such as KOL, Dapp Radar, Atomic Hub, and the WAX Wallet Exchange. And they want to list the token on CoinMarketCap and Binance. That takes a lot of money, okay? And the reason why they can't talk about CoinMarketCap and Binance is because they are under an NDA. Binance could completely revoke them. They could lose all of their progress if they accidentally release the wrong information at the wrong times, okay? So this is a big reason why we're not hearing any sort of update about the IDO. But RuPaz did come out and say that it would be probably the end of the December. So yeah, just look forward to that. Let me get a little bit of a slurp of coffee real quick. Okay, so let's look at a couple other things. Currently, we are having many incentives for the partnership program. They pay 60% of all withdrawal fees that people take that have a referral ID. So like if you refer it on to me and you pull out your money, I get 60% of those exchange fees in order, you know, to be compensated for bringing spotlight to the community. A lot of people try to say that I do have a bias toward this project. I go through the nitty and the gritty. If I see something I don't like, I talk about it, and that is shown in all of my videos. Even when they changed the reward noises, I obviously was a little bit pissed off about it, even though that I don't even have that big of, you know, a hit to be taken from changes like that. It's just something about transparency that made me feel a little bit uneasy. I like things to be transparent. We are on the Wax Network. A lot of people are complaining about the reward noise, and they're not even going into the contracts and looking at anything. They're just making weird speculations without any viable proof or factual evidence behind that. And a few things have changed about this program. So they did change the DRNG system. I don't know if that's had an effect on the reward rates. A lot of people are complaining that they're not getting the averages that they used to get before. You know what? If you're getting less than you used to before, this might be them just trying to work on the governance of the game and trying to keep things stable. Yeah, so I wouldn't be too alarmed about things like that. There is no reason to just be freaking out right now. There's so much profit to be made from projects like this. The Wax Network is a very good network to be on right now. It has transparency. You can track everything. They're not trying to hide anything. There's nothing being swept under the rug that no one can see. Okay, let's go ahead and I want to open up just one of these for now. I am going to consider maybe donating one of these. It really just depends. I'm going to try to work up some sort of system to figure out maybe if I should, you know, push this one out as a donation or if I should hold on to it. Because if it is an ASA, I really do want to hold on to it. And, you know, I want to see the utility that can come from it. Okay, everybody, let's go ahead and we'll start with the lowest mint ID first, 3540. Let's open this puppy up. I'm sure it's going to be an ASA. If it's a stone axe, that's good. I'm happy with anything that I get. Let's go ahead and poof, let's pop this baby open. Come on, mint ID 3540. Give me some luck. What are we going to get? Come on. Reveal. See, I don't get that. Like, I've whitelisted this website numerous times now, and it's still having the same issues. Maybe it's because I have AdBlock Plus turned on. Let me open this in another tab and make sure that we're not going to get destroyed here. I think it did already open it. I'm not 100% sure. Come on. Come on, Nefty. Nefty Blocks has had a lot of issues lately. Okay, so it did obviously open it. Let's go over to my inventory and let's take a peek at what I got. All right. What did we get? So I don't know what's going on here, but it doesn't look like I got the item. Maybe it's in the unclaimed section. I don't know. What in the world is going on with this? So it looks like there has been a little bit of an issue. Let me check the unclaimed packs. Oh, okay. So it is here. Let's go ahead and click review again. We turn the pop-up block off. It did have me like thinking, oh no, did I just lose my item? Okay. So I did get an ASA. That's not that bad. I think it's a good item to have. Let's go ahead and let's take a risk here, everybody. Let's go ahead and open up the next one. I don't really want to open up the lucky packs. I'm really scared to get them damn farmer coins. I'd be a little bit devastated if I did get the farmer coins because it would be like a huge devaluation on the pack price that I paid. Let's open up this other ancient wood pack. Ladies and gentlemen, let's see what we get. If it's another ASA, I'm definitely going to do some sort of a giveaway for it. It is a decent amount of money to be giving away, but you know what? It's good to spread things around. Everybody deserves an equal chance in this world. And you know what? It's good to have extra karma points, right? Come on, Wax. Load that transaction. I do have Anchor, but I just haven't set everything up yet. I do want to experiment with it and, you know, see if it is better. Obviously, it's more secure. Oh, look at that. I got a stone axe from it. Immediate profit. Just boom like that. Oh, that's exciting right there. So I don't think I'm going to give away the ASA just because I do want to hold on to it for the utility. Don't worry, everybody. I'm going to do giveaways no matter what. There's going to be one coming up soon. I've noticed that every time I mention giveaway in my video, there are a couple robots that come into some of my DMs and they're like, oh, here, they just send me their wax wallet adjustment. Come on, at least communicate with me a little bit. Okay, let's go back to Nefty real quick here and let's open up those little love packs. I'm a little bit, you know, I'm a little bit nervous to open these up. If I do get farmer's coins, it's going to be a big slap in the face. I'm going to be a little bit upset, but you know what? It is what it is, and we can't control the outcome, right? We can't control the outcome, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go ahead and open up this bad boy and see what we get. All right, come on, come on, Nefty. Nefty, Nefty, Nefty. Nefty's like a major ball dropper right now because it's just had too much traffic going to it. There's so much things going on. The last Animal World drop was completely horrible. I was so, you know, demotivated after that one. I lost a lot of faith. Oh, small wood token. Hell yeah. That's what I'm talking about, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go ahead and refresh the page and we're going to open up that other one. See what we get. If I get another wood or a gold, I'm definitely going to be crafting something today. Yeah. Come on, Nefty. Don't do me dirty now, Nefty. Don't you dare do me dirty. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, yeah, so please stay tuned because I am going to have a very big event coming soon. I'm still working things out. It's kind of, you know, a project I've been working on. I'm going to try to reward the people that view my channel, and we're going to do it in a very interesting way. So maybe in the next coming video, look at that, two small wood tokens in a row. Oh my goodness, that's absolutely phenomenal. I'm very, very excited about that. Holy crap. Let's go to Farmer's World real quick here. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that if you guys had been tracking me, one of my buddies did push a stone axe in my inventory. See, look, I just got 1.84. I'm not crying about the reward rate. Like, I'm getting good reward rates almost every time I click. I think people are just being a little bit ridiculous. Let's open up these two small wood token packs, ladies and gentlemen. Big hype here, big hype. 600 wood and 1200 wood. It looks like I'm probably going to be buying some gold and I might be crafting a fishing rod again. Let me refresh the page. Just trying to pull up the old asset ID. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, another big tip here. If you're having any sort of problems with, like, you know, just random errors, try another endpoint. There are many good endpoints. The pink.gg is probably one of the best. Alpha EOS is obviously the suggested one. But pink.gg is just as good. It's always good to try other RPC endpoints. Like, as you can see, things are repopulating because I did change over. I'm going to wear this stone axe, baby. Yeah, we're going to be mining with this puppy. You know, I have no quarrels at all with what I just got from the packs. That was really good drops. Two wood packs in a row is extremely exciting. Let's go ahead and look, 1.5 is not bad. Let's go ahead and open up this one. Ooh, 600 wood and then another 600 wood. That's so good. It's so good. It's so exciting. Okay, so now I have 1200 wood, all right. That is good. That is so good. That's like 1208 wax just right there. I didn't even pay that much for the packs. I think, you know, we can go back and look. Can I actually see on the bot what I paid for these packs? No, I would actually have to go into the wax blocks. Let me do that now. IK3, KE dot wham. Boom, shakalaka. Let's go ahead and check this out. I'll tell you exactly how much I paid for the packs. It is, public information. Anyone could go and just click and see what the packs were going for. It'd probably make more sense if I just opened up the drops and did it like that. Let's see. Atomic. Where is it at? Claim drop two. Okay. So right here, I spent 607 wax. So I've doubled the amount of wax that I spent on these packs just by getting lucky on those lucky pack or those little love packs. That is so good. So good. I'm so excited about that. I can't believe I got a stone axe as well. That's so exciting. Everybody, you know how I am. I get excited at things, but you know what? It is genuine and a lot of things just make me happy. I try to stay happy most of the time because you know what? Life is life. If you spend too much time being angry and sad and stuff, it's just not healthy. Stress is a real thing that affects the brain. It's not good for us. So I'm not even gonna attempt to wear this right now because they did say that it won't be in effect until after the drops. Please ignore that. That's obviously not there anymore. I did notice something. If you guys want to refresh the UI and get like actual rates, just spam the hell out of this button for a second. Once you do that, it will refresh. I don't know why it does this, but it does force it to refresh. It'll be like, oh, you don't want to withdraw anything? No way. And then it should refresh. But it's still here. I'm not that worried about it. The chest does have problems like that. So now that I have two stone axes again, I think that I might go ahead and buy a membership for wood. That way I don't have to, be hassled with having to click every 1 hour. It does take some time to do things like this. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, don't feel discouraged about this project. We do have two more drops coming. Let me open this up real quick. This picture is pulled from Atomic Hub. We have two more rounds coming, everyone. The second round is not that far away from now, about 13 days. People, you should be excited about these things. This project is stable right now. The tokens haven't really taken that big of a hit in the last few days. They've been roughly around the same thing. Anybody that was like freaking out about the wood drop or the wood dip, come on, put two and two together. Think of all the whitelisted accounts that didn't get any drops, or they did get drops, and then they just sold their wood, people. This is the reality of the game. This is a market that is open. The value is set to the supply and the demand. Obviously, the supply right now is extremely high. But there are a lot of people that are hoarding their tokens because they do, look at Ir Zhao. This guy is holding his tokens. He's been dumping his wood and stuff, but he's holding everything else. The guy's got like 180,000 food. He's got like, I don't know, 75,000 gold, and he's got 36,000 wood. This guy's not sweating at all. This guy is doing good. The scammy guy is doing good. I don't really want to put spotlight to this guy. There are many things, slap around, But anyways, ladies and gentlemen, I do have some very big things that are going to be coming up soon. I will announce all of the details later. I'm still working out the kinks on it. I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this. I want everything to be within the confines of the law. I don't want any sort of backlash. I want to keep everybody happy. I like to see, everyone's self-esteem come up. So everyone, thank you for coming by. I appreciate you all. And it's more than just appreciation. There's a little bit of love in here. A lot of bit of love, actually. I appreciate every single one of you. Thank you so much for tuning into like my live streams. I also have set up an Instagram and a Twitter account. I've only reserved the usernames. I haven't really done anything else on them lately, but that will change. I'm not really that big into social media, but obviously I do need to get into the loop more. I want to, be more active. And yeah, with all that being said, I appreciate you all and peace out.